another beautiful day. We have had so many beautiful days. There's a nice breeze blowing. Right now it's not too hot. I think it's supposed to get hot later on today, but it is such a beautiful morning. Let's do our hello song. Are you ready? Let's do it with me. You ready? Here we go. Hello, friends. Hello, friends. Hello, friends. It's time to say hello. Hello, everyone. Let's do a calendar while we're waiting for all of our friends to join in. All right. Who remembers what month it is? It is the month of July. And today is a story time day. It is Wednesday. So if we follow Wednesday all the way down to the bottom of July, a 2 and a 9, that makes it a 29. So today is Wednesday, July 29th. And if you notice, look, this is our last story time in July. Next week, it will be a whole new month. Oh, do you know what month comes after July? You'll find out next week. So here is our heart for today's story time. There is our heart for tomorrow's science time. I don't know what Miss Abby's got planned for tomorrow. She hasn't let me know yet. So you'll just have to tune into science time tomorrow for surprise. And now, Friday is the last day of July, so Saturday will be that month, will be the first day of that month. So then, Sunday would be the second, so then on Monday the 3rd, you can't see it because I don't have next month's calendar on there yet, but we've got another story walk in Fallbrook Park. So remember that, 10 to 1, I'll be in Fallbrook Walking Park. It goes around by where the library usually is. And I think it is a book about a duck, maybe. So let's do our days of the week song. Are you ready? Do you remember how many days there are in a week? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let me put our calendar over there. Perfect. All right, show me 7. Here we go. Here's our 7 days. There are 7 days. There are 7 days. There are 7 days in a week. There are 7 days. There are 7 days. There are 7 days in a week. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Yeah. Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Oh my goodness, I messed up our day of the week song. Oh, so yesterday's story time. I did a contest. If you put "everyone counts" in the comment section, I put you into a drawing. So I'm going to do a live drawing of the people, "everyone counts," in the comment section. Are you ready? If you were tuning in yesterday, or if you didn't tune in yesterday, drum roll, let's see who wins that prize bag full of goodies. Are you ready? Let's see whose name is on this little piece of paper. It is, you can't see it, but it says Miss Cheryl. Yay, Cheryl! We'll arrange for prize pickup later. And for everybody else that I owe prizes to, I did prize giveaways in, like, oh my goodness, for Earth Day. I've got a stack of those recyclable bags. You guys need to get a hold of me so we can arrange for pickup of your prizes. All right, so congratulations, Miss Cheryl. We've done our calendar. Now we're going to quickly do our weather. So go look out your window or your front door. And what is the weather at your house? What's the weather? What's the weather? What's the weather out today? What's the weather? What's the weather? What's the weather out today? All right, come back, come back, come back. And what is the weather at your house? At my house, guess what? It's another sunny day. So I'm going chart. There we go. And look, our sunny days are almost full. We might have to do a new weather chart next week, too. Oh, so much fun. All right, let's put our weather chart down there. And let's do a story. I've got some pretty silly stories today. I was sitting on the farm, happy as can be. Except I had a bug sitting on my knee. I said, "Hey, bug, get off my knee." But that bug said, "No, siree." So I used my telephone and I called my friend Frog. And I said, "Hey, Frog, would you like to come for lunch?" So Frog came over and said, "Yummy bug. Mum, 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 mum. Munch, munch, munch." Well, I was sitting on the farm, happy as can be. But now I have a frog sitting on my knee. I said, "Hey, frog, get off my knee." But that frog said, "No, siree." So I used my telephone and I called my friend Snake. And I said, "Hey, Snake, would you like to come for lunch?" So Snake came over and said, "Munch, munch, munch." Well, now I was sitting on the farm, happy as can be. Now the snake sitting on my knee. I said, "Hey, Snake, get off my knee." But that snake said, "No, siree." So I used my telephone and I called my friend Rat. And I said, "Hey, Rat, would you like to watch?" So Rat came over and said, "Munch, munch, munch." I was sitting on the farm, as can be. But now there's a rat sitting on my knee. I said, "Hey, Rat, get off my knee." But that rat said, "No, siree." So I used my telephone and I called my friend Cat. And I said, "Hey, Cat, would you like to come for lunch?" So Cat came over and said, "Munch, munch, munch." I was sitting on the farm, happy as can be. And now there's a cat sitting on my knee. I said, "Hey, Cat, get off my knee." But that cat said, "No, siree." So I used my telephone and I called my friend Dog. And I said, "Hey, Dog, would you like to come have lunch?" So Dog came over and went, "Woo, woo, 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 woo." Munch, munch, munch. And I'm sitting on the farm, happy as can be. And now there's a dog sitting on my knee. I said, "Hey, Dog, get off my knee." But that dog said, "No, siree." So I used my telephone and I called my friend Bear. And I said, "Hey, Bear, would you like to come have lunch?" Now Bear came over and said, "Munch, munch, munch." Now I'm sitting on the farm, happy as can be. But now there's a bear sitting on my knee. I said, "Hey, Bear, get off my knee." But that bear said, "No, siree." So I used my telephone. Does anybody know who I called to get a bear off my knee? And that story is called Sitting on the Farm. Oh, great story, huh? All right, let's move that over there. Because now, does anybody recognize where I am? We did story time from my orchard in the springtime, and I told you that the tree we're going to very carefully move the camera. But in the summertime, look at the job that those bees did. Do you see all those apples on my trees? That's the importance of bees going around to all those flowers to pollinate. Now there are apples in my orchard, and those apples are going to grow and grow and grow all summer. So in September and October, I'll have apples to eat. Oh, if I love summertime, all that growing. All right, so this story was originally called What's in Fox's Sack? But guess what? I couldn't find my fox puppet this morning. So today it's going to be What's in Coyote's Sack? Oh, here is Coyote. We have a lot of coyotes around my house. I don't see them very often, but I can hear them at nighttime. So this is Coyote. And Coyote, he always carried this green sack with him. Never know when you might find something you want to put in a sack. So one day, Coyote, he was out on the farm with his green sack. And he was doing a little digging. He was digging and digging. And guess what Coyote found? He found a great big fat bee. And Coyote looked at that bee and said, you know what? That bee? That'll make a pretty good snack for my apple. So Coyote, he took that bee and he put it in his sack. And he closed up that sack so the bee couldn't get out. He put that sack over his shoulder and the Coyote started walking down the road. Now, Coyote, pretty soon he came to a house. Now, he was thinking about going to visit a friend of his, but you know, when you go and visit a friend, you better take enough snack or two. Coyote did not want to share that snack with his friend. So when he came to that house, he went up and very politely he knocked on the door. He went knock, 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 knock. And when the lady who owned the house, when she opened up the door, Coyote said, "Excuse me, ma'am, but you know, I'm going to go visit a friend of mine, and I don't want to carry this sack all the way to his house. Could I be here with you?" "Sure," said the lady. "Just leave it right there." Now, Coyote looked at that lady and said, "Don't open my sack." "Okay," said the old lady. So, Coyote, he put his sack right there next to the door, and then Coyote, he walked on down the road. Now, the minute Coyote got out of eyesight of that house, that old lady, she went over to that sack. And even though Coyote told her not to open it, guess what she did? She opened that sack. Well, now, when she opened the sack, of course, the bee wasn't happy, closed into that sack. The bee flew out. Bzzz. Now, this old lady, she had a rooster. Now, roosters, they love to eat bees, too, just like Coyote. So, rooster ate that bee. Uh-oh. Well, after a while, Coyote came back. And he picked up his sack. Uh-oh. Coyote noticed that the sack was open. He looked at the old lady and said, "What happened to the bee that I had in this sack?" Well, the old lady looked at Coyote and said, "Mr. Coyote, I know you told me not to look in that sack, but I'm sorry, I did. And when I looked in your sack, the bee flew out and my rooster ate your bee. I'm very sorry, Mr. Coyote." "Oh, really?" said Mr. Coyote. "Well, if your rooster ate my bee, then I guess I should take your rooster." And that's exactly what the coyote did. He caught her rooster, put her rooster in the sack, closed it up, put that sack over his shoulder, and then Coyote started walking away. I started off with a bee, but now I have a rooster. That rooster is going to take delicious. He was walking down the road, but a rooster is a tad bit heavier than a bee. So he thought about visiting another friend, but he didn't really want to carry that sack all the way to his friend's house. So the next house he came to, he went up and he knocked on the door. Knock, 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 knock. And there was a woman. She opened the door. And Coyote looked at her and said, "Excuse me, but I was going to go visit a friend's house, and I'm carrying this sack, and the sack is kind of heavy. Would you mind if I left my sack here at your house while I go and visit my friend, and then I'll come back for my sack?" And the lady said, "Well, sure. Just put it right there on the ground." So Coyote, he put his sack down. But then he looked at the lady and said, "Don't open my sack." "I won't," said the lady. So now Coyote, he walked off down the road, leaving his sack. Now, the same thing happened. Coyote no longer got out of sight of that house, and that lady, she went over, she picked up Coyote's sack, and she opened it. Now, of course, when she opened it, the rooster got out. And the rooster was running around all over the place. Now this lady, she had a pig. Now pigs, they like to chase roosters. So that pig started chasing the rooster. And that pig chased and chased and chased that rooster until the rooster was gone. Uh-oh. Well, after a while, Coyote came back. He went over and he picked up his sack. Uh-oh. He noticed it was open. He looked at the lady and said, "What happened to the rooster I had in this sack?" And the lady looked at Coyote and said, "I know, Mr. Coyote, I know you told me not to open that sack, but I did. And when I opened it, your rooster got out. I'm very, very sorry, Mr. Coyote, but my pig chased your rooster away." "Oh, really?" said the coyote. "Well, if your pig chased my rooster, then I guess I get your pig." So Coyote, he went over, he caught that pig, and he put the pig in the sack. He tied that sack closed, threw it over his shoulder, and Coyote started walking down the road. "Interesting day," said Mr. Coyote. "I started off with just a bee, but now I have a pig. Oh, this pig will taste so delicious." But a pig it's much heavier than a bee or a rooster. Yes, I should probably find some place where I could keep this pig till later. Yeah. Kind of heavy to carry it around. So the very next house he came to, he went up and he knocked on the door. Knock, 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 knock. Well, the door was opened by another woman, and Coyote looked at her and said, "Excuse me, ma'am, but I've got a lot of errands to do, and I'm carrying this sack, and the sack is very heavy. Would you mind if I left my sack here while I do my errands? And then I'll come back for it later." "Sure," said the woman. "Just leave it right there." So Coyote, he put his sack down and he looked at the woman and said, "Don't open my sack." "I won't," promised the lady. All right, so Coyote left his sack and then he went walking down the road. Now again, as soon as Coyote got out of the house, the lady, that woman, she went over, she opened up the sack, and what do you think happened? Of course, the pig, it came running out of the sack. Well, now there's a pig running around in her kitchen. Now, this woman had a son. Now, he was a very, very good boy, and he knew pigs do not belong in the house. So he took a stick, and he scared that pig right out of the house, chased it right down the road. Uh-oh. coyote came back. He picked up his sack. He looked inside. He looked at the woman and said, "What happened to the pig that was in my sack?" Now the woman looked at Coyote and she said, "I know I promised I would not look in your sack, but I did. And the minute I did, your pig came running out. And my boy, oh, he's such a good boy. He knew I've worked so hard to get the house clean. And he knew that that pig should not have been in the house. So I'm sorry, Mr. Coyote, but my boy chased your pig away."
"Really?"
said Mr. Coyote. "Well, if your boy chased away my pig, then I guess I get to take your boy." And that's exactly what Coyote did. He took that boy and he put the boy in the sack. He tied that bag closed, put the bag over his shoulder, and he went walking down the road. Oh, what fortune I've had today, said Coyote. I started off with a bee, but then I got a rooster and then a pig, but now I have a whole boy. Oh, this boy is going to taste delicious. I can make boy stew, said the coyote. Oh, but to make boy stew, I'm going to need some other ingredients. Carrots, potatoes, and undo. Oh, yes, I'm going to have to go and gather ingredients. This boy is rather heavy. Maybe I should leave the boy while I go and gather the rest of the ingredients for my boy's stew. Yes, that way I won't have to carry him around all day long. So the very next house Coyote came to, he went up and he knocked on the door. Knock, 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 knock. And of course, a woman came and answered the door. Coyote looked at her and said, "Excuse me, ma'am, but I need to do a little grocery shopping. But I've got this heavy sack here. Do you mind, could I leave my sack here with you while I go and get my groceries, and then I'll be back for my sack in a while?" And the woman said, "Sure, leave it there in the corner. I'm just so busy. Just leave it there." And now Coyote looked at her and said, "Don't open my sack." And the woman said, "Coyote, I do not have time to look in your sack. I've got all these cookies to make. I've got dishes to do. I've got a house to clean. I've got laundry to do. I do not have time to open your sack." All right. So Coyote left his sack and he went to gather his ingredients for boy stew. Now, the sack sat there in the corner of the house. And this lady, she was so busy. She had tons and tons of cookies to make. She popped the first batch of the cookies into the oven, and after just a few minutes, the smell of fresh cookies baking, oh, the smell went all through that kitchen. And in a little while, she heard a voice. "Those cookies smell good. Can I have one?" Who said that? She looked all over her kitchen. She was the only one home. And then she heard it again. "Boy, those cookies, they smell so good. Can I please have one?" She looked around. The voice was coming from inside that sack. So she went over and she opened up the sack. And there she found the little boy. And she looked at that little boy and she said, "Oh, you poor thing. That coyote, he was going to eat you." "No, we'll teach that coyote a lesson." Now, this lady, she had a guard dog. Oh, he was a great guard dog. And she said, "I will show that coyote and I will teach him a lesson." She took her guard dog and she put her guard dog in the sack. She put that guard dog in the sack. She tied it up just like Mr. Coyote had done it. She left it sit right there in the same spot that Coyote had left it. So then, when Coyote came back, Coyote looked. Oh, yes. He picked up his sack. Oh, yes, his boy was still in there. So Coyote, he took that sack, he flung it over his shoulder, and he said, "Thank you very much for coming back." And then Coyote, he started walking down the road to his house. Oh, and he thought about Boy Stew the whole way. Oh, this Boy Stew is going to taste so delicious. This boy, oh, this boy is so heavy. I'll make a big enough Boy Stew. I'll have to eat it for days. Oh, yes, I can have leftover Boy Stew. Delicious. Now, Coyote, he built a house, and he built a nice fire, and he put a nice big pot of water on that fire to boil. And now, when it was just about ready to boil, he said, "Time to add the boy to my stew." So he went over, and he opened up the sack. And when he reached in to take out the boy, imagine his surprise when he pulled out that guard dog. Well, the guard dog, he was such a great guard dog, chased the coyote away. And then the guard dog went back home to his owner, where his owner, she gifted him two of those delicious smelling cookies. How about that? Wasn't that a great story? And guess what, friends? It is time for us to say goodbye. So let's sing our goodbye song. Are you ready? Do it with me. Goodbye, friends. Goodbye, friends. Goodbye, friends. It's time to say goodbye. Goodbye, friends. Make sure you put in the comment section how many of you are watching.